Is it possible to be homesick for a place you have never been? My son, I was born on Earth, but I think I have been homesick for Europa my whole life. The view from up here is like nothing else I've seen. By the time you read this, I'll be gone, and the world will look very different from how it does now. But the island should still be there. They built this thing to last. Come to the island if you ever get lonely. Come here and think of me. It has surpassed my expectations in every way, this place. I don't know what I expected. They've given me a few days to adjust, but I can't make my mind believe that this is real. The air tastes like water, and the water tastes like wine. The gardeners have turned this place into a paradise. friends of the past can stay home on Earth, things will be different this time. They have to be. You'll never see our home world, but I can't say I regret bringing you here. You're going to have everything I couldn't have. Clean water, fresh air, wide open skies. Everything a child deserves. That's what I want for you. And you'll have community too. Human beings to play with and learn from and grow alongside. Every person here has a difference. Some say that humans brought life to Europa. If you ask me, all we did was unlock the life that was sleeping within. Why have so many terraforming projects failed where this one succeeded? It can only be that Europa holds some innate capacity for life. Look at the gardeners. They came to this moon as mere tools to prepare for our arrival. But through 1,000 years, they've evolved into a whole ecosystem mimicking the biodiversity of old Earth. I can't wait to learn more about these creatures, to live among them. They're our family now.
Thank you.
Look at the gardeners. They came to this moon as mere tools to prepare for our arrival. But through 1,000 years, they've evolved into a whole ecosystem mimicking the biodiversity of old Earth. I can't wait to learn more about these creatures, to live among them. They are family now. Look. As I'm writing this, most of the human race are still asleep on the island. In a few years' time, you're going to join them. I'll stay back here and work, so that when you wake up, you'll wake up somewhere better. I don't know exactly what the world will look like. All I know is that people on the homeworld made the mistake of not thinking past tomorrow by sending you ahead. I'm staking my heart on the future. The greatest pleasure in my life is watching you watch the world. New faces, passing ships, whatever new sight catches your attention. You drink everything in like you're hungry for it. You also spend a lot of time putting things in your mouth which are not food. Another kind of intellectual curiosity, I suppose. Yeah. So much I want to tell you, so much to teach, but at the same time, I don't want to smother your innate desire to learn things yourself. Civilizations collapse when we stop letting children ask questions. If Europa is going to survive, we'll need to raise a generation who are not just curiously determined, but determinedly curious. I hope you can grow up that way, my son.
Yeah.
fresh air, wide open skies. Everything a child deserves. That's what I want for you. The greatest pleasure in my life is watching you watch the world. There's so much I want to tell you. So much to teach. Catalog as many gardener species as I can. There are bipedal gardener bugs, small enough even you can grab them with those tiny hands. Quite a contrast with their wind-breathing cousins, some of which are as big as buildings. At night, I can hear them lowing overhead. To think all this variety evolved from a single generation of Terraformer AI. Yesterday, there was a near miss. One of the Leviathans nearly collided with a ship. We have to be careful how we behave with the gardeners. They have been here far longer than we have and are more in tune with the planet's rhythms. If we don't learn from them, I fear we will be in for a struggle. I tried my best, but they wouldn't listen. This is supposedly the safe thing to do. What's the harm of turning off faulty machinery? The sound it made as they pulled it to the ground, it did not sound very machine-like to me. Tried my best, but they wouldn't listen. This is supposedly the safe thing to do. What's the harm of turning off faulty machinery? The sound it made as they pulled it to the ground, it did not sound very machine-like to me. Thank you. There's been another incident, a serious one this time down at the mines. A herd of gardeners charged through the valley just as the day's shift was ending, and they collided with the crowd. We did what we could, but some people didn't make it. The most distressing thing is we can't identify what caused the stampede. It came at the worst possible moment, almost like an attack. Could the gardeners be turning hostile? I pray it's not so. Aside from the stampede, there have been smaller issues with the gardeners. For example, the pollinator bites. Nothing deadly, a mere annoyance. They nip on the arm and fly away. But there are parts of the colony where the pollinators do not bite at all. In fact, they don't even have teeth. The attacks are concentrated in areas of maximum disruption, at the logging camps and mines and resource extraction sites. The greater the disruption, the more frequently the bites occur. Deep in the gardener's coding is a directive to resist anything that would make the planet unlivable. Our actions must be triggering this resistance. They are trying to protect us from ourselves. Just how lively. It seemed like only yesterday you were learning to wriggle across the ground. Now if I don't keep hold of you, you'll sprint out of my workshop and into the meadows. You love playing with the gardeners, large or small. They don't seem to frighten you one bit. Fine day today. The air has the clarity of early winter, and I have a view right down the valley. I only wish I was riding with better news. There's been a long stretch of peace, but I'm afraid this idiotic conflict has sprung up again. As we fight the gardeners, we teach them to fight. They are evolving their own weaponry. Detonators and heat-seeking rays, mirroring us, outgrowing us, twisting the land into a fortress. Change is what permits life. It is life itself. If you can worship change, you will find nothing else to fear. Turning to us tenfold. It is the same story as what happened on the homeworld, only here it is occurring at a terrifying pace. reputation as an eccentric, because I will not leave the ground. Eccentric, because I will not leave the ground, because I do not run screaming from every non-human creature that I see, and worst of all, I allow my son to play freely with the gardeners, our enemies in this so-called war. Perhaps it is foolish, but you have never feared them before, and they seem content to let you clamber over their knees and catch them out of the air. The gardeners are still peaceful where we live, but the safe air is our shrinking. I've decided to put you in stasis soon. Your 6th birthday, perhaps, or that's only a few months away. I must treasure the time we have left. Crystals are our primary source of energy. Without them, much of our current technology would cease to work. Why does it always come down to energy? Every conflict in the history of our species has been a contest for energy, or some expression of it. Manpower, food, fuel. We act like it's scarce, but there's nothing more abundant in the world than energy. Everything trembles with it. How were our ancestors able to convert Europa from a lifeless moon into the paradise it is today? Fighting for energy is quite fighting for the air. This is no time to write, but I don't know what else to do. I don't know how else to order my thoughts. I decided it was finally time for us to set out for the island. I had already delayed too long. The thought of saying goodbye to you hurt too much. As we were drawing closer, we came under attack. That thing, the Guardian, it now has us trapped in here. All the knowledge in the world can't help us. I have never felt so helpless. I'm sorry. Your father is a fool.
Thank you.
Something incredible has happened. It seems you have a relationship with that guardian. Something deeper than I could have possibly imagined. Neither of you made a sound, but you understood each other. Have you met before? Or is this just something you can do? Some innate understanding of the gardeners that even I do not possess? You saved my life. 6 years old and you've somehow become wiser than me. It is not too late. We are creating this conflict and we have the power to stop it. All we have to do is remove this false sense of difference between ourselves and the gardeners. We are one organism. They are calling it war, but it is not war when an organism destroys itself. It is a sickness. The cure, my son. And when we get to the island, I will tell them what you did. We will show everybody the light.
Thank you.
We arrived at the island too late. Too late. It was hell. Armored guardians had arrived. They were locked in battle, weapons flashing. You ran out into the center. You must have thought you could stop them, that they were your friends. You went too fast. I couldn't stop you. I don't even know who it was. Outside, there's something hit you. I ran into the fray, but it was already too late. You can't be gone. I can't accept it. I won't. Self-pity won't help me now. All these years of study, it can't be just for nothing. I'm not so powerless, am I? The battle has ended for now, but the island is littered with gardener remains. There are scraps here, materials. It's not too late. I'll fix this no matter what it takes. I'll save you, see. To hell with these people. They'll be dead soon enough. They refuse to stop fighting, to stop the sickness. Once the gardeners wipe them out, there'll be nobody left except me. Me and my creation. Hey, he does as he is told. Or maybe I should say you. Is that you in there, Z? Are you really my little boy? You're breathing and listening and moving around, but you don't ask questions anymore. I don't know if you can even speak. So much has been lost in the transition. Was it too much? Maybe the others are right. Maybe I have done something terrible. Maybe you are nothing more than a mechanized corpse and I am just a foolish old engineer, driven crazy by grief. No, I am certain that you are the key, my son, that you can be again with time. The others are wrong. Half of them blindly throw themselves into conflict, and the other half hope to sleep until it's all over. But who will be left to wake them? And how will they know when the time has come? We will return home to continue our work in peace, you and I. We will find a way to exist in the world as it is now. I can only hope that you will outlive all of this. It is calm tonight. It is calm nearly everywhere now. After everything, I'm still awed by this world we have created. But more than that, I'm awed by you, Z. As time goes on and we travel home together, you appear to be doing more than simply existing. It is almost as if you are thinking, choosing, I can't be sure, but I will observe you even closer now. I have this idea. Maybe it could be you, my little boy. The one who decides. The one who makes the decision when, if, humanity should come back to Europa. Can you? Should you? And what would you choose if you did? Thank you. human side of you will grow over time. Empathy, curiosity. It might take decades, but those will grow back. Maybe those will return for me as well. We can grow together. The last of the human settlers will be gone soon enough. But what about the others? The ones in stasis? Do they deserve a second chance? Do we, as a collective? You have so much to teach them, Z. If you found these journals, if you've remembered who you are, who I am, then maybe you can guide the next generation down a better path. But will they listen? I don't know. That's the brutal truth of it. Despite everything I've been through, I still don't know if there's any hope for us. If anyone can decide about tomorrow, it's you. Whatever you turn out to be, whoever you choose to become, however the human and inhuman meld inside your consciousness,